Hello children, today we are starting the next lesson, that is lesson number 3, and lesson name is the integer. Before starting the lesson, we will just recall. Observe the picture, all of you. If you see this picture, you will see some boys are there, they are standing, okay. Some flowers are here in the picture. After some, here is a tree, and on tree there are leaves are there. After some swans are there, they are swimming in the pond. Okay, so these things are there, as we can see in the picture. Now we will see what is the questions they are asking regarding to this picture. Count how many boys. Okay, see here, one. How many boys are there? Count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. How many boys are there? 7 boys are there. Okay. Now we have count objects order flowers. Can we measure the flower? Count the flowers here. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. How many flowers are there total here? There are 15 flowers are there. How many ducks are there in this pond? How many are there? The 4 ducks are there in the picture. Okay, so we have to count objects in order to find out the answer how many. If how many is the question, you have to count the object. How many boys are there? What is the, how many boys are there in your class? How many girls are there in your class? How many total numbers of students are there in our school? So at that time, what we are doing, we are counting the number of boys, girls, and total. So we are getting the answer of how many. Now numbers were created because of counting things in the nature. Okay, for counting we need the numbers, and for that purpose what happens, we are using the numbers. We write the counting of things in the form of numbers. Okay, we write the count of things in the form of numbers. Okay, now if I will ask you how many letters are there in English alphabet, so immediately you will tell that there are 26 alphabets in the English letter. So in that way you can just answer the question in the numbers. Okay, and these numbers are used for what purpose? For counting. Okay, now we will discuss some of the, here there is a discussion in between Dada and Samir. Okay, so this children is there, this boy is like you, Samir, and he is conversating with his big brother, that is Dada. Okay, so what is their conversation? First of all we will see, and then we will start the next part of integers. Okay, so see, Dada, what said? The number 1, 2, 3, 4, the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 that we have used up to now, counting is called as a counting numbers. Just now I ask you, how many letters are there in English alphabet, how many ovals are there, how many boys are there, how many benches are there in your class. So this time you are using the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 100, 1000, lakh. Okay, at that time these numbers we are telling as what? This is called as a counting numbers. They also called as a natural numbers. Okay, these counting numbers only we are called as a natural number. But it is possible to count the stars in the sky or grains in the sand on a beach. Okay, suppose sand we are taken, beach is there, see a beach, on that beach sand is there, and from that beach we can measure, count the grains. So their answer is they are innumerable, we cannot count it. So they are called as a natural numbers. Look at this natural numbers. Okay, see here natural number, here 1, 2, 3, 4, afterwards 321, 322, then 28,573. Suppose any number you like, 5,00,000, 6,00,000, 775,946. Okay, in that way the numbers are there, these all numbers are called as a natural numbers. Okay, so natural numbers how we are writing, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, numbers starting from 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, and so on, all the numbers. Okay, if you see all the numbers, they are Okay, so these are the natural numbers. All natural numbers onwards, one onwards, all the natural numbers we are taking as a, these are the natural numbers. Okay, now all this information is provided by whom? Dada. On this information, what is Samir asking? We have already learned all addition, add, subtract these numbers. Okay, you know the addition of the numbers, subtraction of a natural numbers. Okay, but we subtract 5 from 5. 5 from 5. Suppose this is 5 minus 5, answer is 0. Yes, so the 0 that we write to show that is not seen in this list. So what he said, that Samir said that 5 minus 5 equals to 0, and that 0 is not there in this natural numbers list. So Dada said that of course we cannot do without 0. What he said, that Dada said that we cannot do without 0. The set of all natural numbers together with 0 is the set of whole numbers. Okay, now in natural number inside, if we are adding the 0, then this set is called as a natural numbers set. Okay, so what I said, that here I will show you. First of all, I will write the natural NT. NT I will write here, natural numbers. So N I will write here, natural numbers. So natural numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Okay, all the numbers on one onwards, all the numbers, 1 lakh, 1 crore, 1 means this 1 crore 536, whatever you are taking, all these numbers are the which numbers? These are the natural numbers. Then what is whole numbers? So from above conversation we are understanding that if we are adding, suppose these natural numbers I will write here 2 3 4 5 and so on, so number, and in it only if you are adding the 0, the set of this number is called as a whole numbers. Okay, clear? Now we will see this part. So what is the definition of the zero numbers? The set of natural numbers together with 0 is called as a whole number. The set of natural numbers together with 0 is called as a whole number, and all counting numbers are natural numbers, is the definition of natural number. Now here see Dada, we need to use some other numbers which are not in this group. Which are those? Salma is asking. Okay, Salma is asking, which are those numbers that we are not using? So here Dada said that here is an example. Here is the examples in Maharashtra: temperature falls of 10 degree Celsius. Falls of 10 degree Celsius means it becomes reduced. So this number we are adding, minus 10 degree Celsius. Okay, if you are reading, watching the news, then inside it the temperatures they are showing, and some places like the cold places are there, their temperature is below 0 degree Celsius, and that we are writing as a minus 10 degree Celsius. Okay, or even in 8 degree Celsius in the 8 degree Celsius in the winter. So false means we have to write 8 degree, but we are not down to 0 degree Celsius, but Kashmir it may falls on 0 degree Celsius to show that the need that number is less than 0. So this minus 10 degree Celsius, minus 8 degree Celsius, these numbers are there, these are smaller than 0. Okay, so these numbers are not looking in the whole numbers list and natural numbers list. Okay, these he said that Dada. Okay, now we will move forwards. Samir, now Samir is asking, in January when the paper is said that was snowing in Kashmir, the temperature of Srinagar was minus 8 degree Celsius, how to read this, how do we read that? So Dada said that it is read minus 8 degree Celsius. Okay, this is minus, this is 8, this is a sign of degree, and this is Celsius. How to read this? Minus 8 degree Celsius. Okay, ready? If I will write this minus 10 degree, this is a sign of degree Celsius. Okay, in this way we are reading. When we put minus sign before any number, the number obtained less than 0. If I will write here minus 100, this number is also smaller than 0, means 0 is greater than negative number. Any number, negative numbers, the greater the negative number, smaller is its value. Understand? And if the numbers are positive, if I will take here 100, if I will take here 100, this 100 is greater than 0. What I said that if I will write here minus 100, it is smaller than 0, but plus 100 is greater than 0. Okay, so minus the number, it is small, it is small, and greater is the number, okay, which is positive numbers are greater than the negative numbers. Okay, now we will move towards in this conversation. See here, any number, the number obtained is less than 0 is called as a, which, these are called as a negative numbers. Okay, these negative numbers are smaller than, keep this thing in your mind that the negative numbers are always less than or smaller than 0. On the thermometer, there are increasing numbers like 1, 2, 3, above 0. These are called as a positive numbers. Okay, it is not necessary to write the positive 5. If you write an only 5, then it is positive only. So, it is not necessary to write the positive number in front of positive sign. In front of positive numbers, okay, so these both are the positive. If you write the plus sign, it is not necessary to write the plus sign, okay. So these 1, 2, 3, these are the positive numbers, but negative sign you have to write there, okay, then only we said that these are the negative. So here negative 1, negative 2 and negative 3. Can we show the negative numbers on a number line? Yeah, yes, we can show these negative numbers on a number line. Okay, I will draw here number line. Okay, if you, I will draw, first of all, you see here, this is my number line. Okay, so in that number line, if I have to write the numbers, so center is, it is the 0. Here it is plus 1. Here 2. I told you that it is not necessary to write the positive sign. So this is 3. This is 4. This is 5. This is number line. It extends both the side. There is no limit. But minus 1, you have to write, it is necessary to write the negative sign. So this, I am writing the negative sign here. This is minus 1. This is minus 2. This is minus 3. Okay. And here so on, minus 4. In this way, negative signs are there. Negative numbers we are writing. This is a 0 and the left side of the negative. This is the left side of the number line. And negative numbers we are writing left side of a number line. And positive numbers we are writing towards the right side of a number line. Okay. So, up to here, this all of you understand? Okay. So, what is the question that is asked by whom? Samir, can we write the negative numbers on a number line? Its answer is yeah. Yes, we can write the numbers on the negative numbers on a number line. Of course, what Dada said that, of course, on the right of 0, at a distance of 1, 2, 3, units are the number positive. And left of the 0, 1, 2, 3, unit distance are numbers are negative. Okay. So, the left side, just now I shown you number 9, the left side, there is a negative numbers, and right side of 0, there is a positive, there are positive numbers. They are called as a negative numbers. The numbers 1, 2, 3, they are towards the right side, those are called as a positive numbers. Okay, now what is Salma is asking? Salma, on the thermometer, what's he saying? On the thermometer, the positive numbers are above 0 and negative numbers are below it. Okay, so on the number line, there are on right and left side, what I said that, suppose this is a number line, what I said, it is 0, then this side positive numbers are there, means 1, 2, 3, 4 in that way, and this side minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, in this way numbers we are writing. But thermometer is, it's a, how is the thermometer? Thermometer is, I will show you here, thermometer is a straight, what I said, thermometer is a straight. So, and it is not in horizontal position, it is vertical position. So on that number, this is suppose a thermometer, this is thermometer, and that thermometer inside this number line is there, okay. And on that number line, if 0 is here, what I said, if 0 is here, okay, above the number, above the 0, okay, above the 0, there are positive numbers. What I said, above the 0, there are positive numbers, and below the 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 2, minus 3, and so on. Okay, in this way, the negative numbers are there, it is below 0. Okay, so what they told you, on the number thermometer, the positive numbers are above the 0. So this here, this is thermometer, and positive numbers are above the 0, and the negative numbers are below it, and negative numbers are below the 0. Okay, on the number line, they are on the right and left 0 respectively. Does it mean that positive and negative numbers are positive? Numbers are opposite side of 0. Yes, if we see this number line, here it is 0, here 1, 2, 3, in that way, and here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, it is in that way. Okay, so from this what we are understanding, zeros, right side, one side of 0, the positive numbers, and the one side of 0, there is a negative number. Same way here also, above the number 0, positive numbers, and below the 0, negative numbers are there. Okay, so it is correct, the Salma said that the zeros opposite side, positive and number, negative numbers are located. Is it correct? So Dada said that, yeah, yes, it's correct. Then what is Samir said? Then should we use positive numbers to show height above the sea level and negative number to depth of the sea level? Okay, yes. So you are right too, and very good. If you see, this is sea level, and if you go above, so mountains are there above sea level, is this, suppose it is what I said, sea level. Okay, if you go above the sea level, though we have to take its height positive. But sometimes what happens, if we go under the sea, otherwise under the ground, okay, so these numbers we have to write a negative. Okay, till that clear, all of you? So the sign, positive sign, is generally not written before the positive number, just I told you. And however, it is necessary to write negative sign. Negative numbers, 0 does not have any sign. But if you write positive 0, negative 0, then this is wrong. 0 doesn't have any sign. 0 doesn't have any sign. So 0 we have to write as it is only. If you write the positive 0, then also wrong. Negative 0, then also it is wrong. Clear till then? So today we learn that the natural numbers are starting from what I told you, the 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. All numbers are natural numbers. If you add 0 in the natural numbers, you will get the number of sets of which whole numbers. So these are the whole numbers, WH for whole numbers, and NN for natural number. And these zeros, right side positive numbers are there, and zeros, left side negative numbers are there. Okay, and these all numbers are what happens, positive numbers, and all positive numbers, what I said. So if this is a number line, 0 is towards this, his center, positive numbers are towards here. Okay, and negative numbers are towards here, this side, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. Okay, and these all these numbers, all positive numbers, all negative numbers, and 0 together, it is called as a group of integers. What I said, all positive numbers, 0, and all negative numbers together form a group of integer. Okay, so all of you understand today what we learned, that the natural numbers, whole numbers, and the integer. Till that, we will stop now, and next part of the lesson we will see tomorrow. Okay, bye.